Okay, you're going right in the window. Okay.
All right. I mean, I see you. If you get those long giraffe legs in here.
Model legs.
Oh, yeah, they are model legs. All right. Howdy, friend.
What's going on, brother?
We've got special guest today.
Cleeter McSkeeter.
Cleeter McSkeeter. Cleetus McFarland.
Sittin' with Gittin.
For Sittin' with Gittin. Exactly. Welcome to my Fox body. This is the Fun Haver Fox. This was actually out of Abby, my wife's 240SX.
You're really tall.
A little angle adjustment.
You're really blowing it. All right, we're just gonna keep it there. We're just gonna keep it flowing.
We'll
yeah.
Just keep it rolling.
You good? Okay. Camera set. Looking good. Thanks, Preston.
Okay, a little adjustment there. We're gonna go with the flow.
So as you can see, this is the Fun Haver Fox. You got a set of pedals under there. We're not driving it today, but maybe later this weekend. Because here.
This is a system, right? Brother.
I got switches here.
What does this valve do?
So this is for a line lock, but this is how you switch it from driver brake to the passenger brake.
Okay, rad.
Yep. Cool. We'll get into that later. But anyway, here I do this thing, Sittin' with Gittin, which you're aware of. I interview some cool people.
Yep.
And just chat.
I'm honored to be a cool person, be a part of the group.
Yeah. And so we are here for Burnout Rivals.
Yes.
Which is a very fun event that you had dreamed up, and you said, hey, Vaughn.
Oh, man.
I want you guys to come party.
Yeah, so we got a big day ahead of us tomorrow.
We do.
We got freestyle drifting, which I'm going to be honest, I'm nervous about it. You know, I haven't even driven my car yet, so.
And you're a new drifter, too.
Let alone to be competing against you and Chelsea and Taylor and Adam. It's going to be crazy. But I don't know. I'm just going to send it and figure it out later.
It's been a lot of fun watching you. We met, let's see. Well, first of all, I thought I first met you at Holly Ford Fest last year.
Yeah.
In Kentucky.
Which hasn't even been a year.
It hasn't. It's been 7-8 months.
Yeah.
And so we met and became pretty fast friends, I would say.
Yeah, for sure.
And so since then, a lot of things have happened, but we also realized that I met you when you were, 16? Tell me that story.
I was either 17 or something like that. I had flown to SEMA and got in with someone else's pass with a 1320 video camera and interviewed Vaughn, which is a video worth watching. It's titled Drifting at SEMA. And I was like, hey, Vaughn, can I get a video? Vaughn's like, you damn kid? Yeah. I'm
okay. Not at all, but yeah.
He was super cool. He was like, come on over. And he like invited me back by the booth because there was kind of a fence up. And I was like, this is so amazing. And I was calling my boss and I was like, dude, I've got a video with Vaughn and Ryan. And I filmed it. And like, you can even see in the angle, like I'm down, I'm shorter. And dude, it was cool. And then I went for a ride with Ryan Turk while we chased your car.
Yep.
It was just amazing, man. It was so cool.
Yeah, so we figured that out, or I figured that out, because like, when we met at Holly Ford Fest, I had known about you and what you're doing and really liked some of your stuff. And then I didn't even know that like that was you then, and you reminded me. So anyway, so now we're here at your track, the Freedom Factory, you own a track.
Know,
you bought a track.
Questionable, but awesome decision.
Right.
Honestly, it's the most life-changing thing I've ever done in my existence.
Why is that?
You know, it just changed my whole outlook on everything, man. It's like, it's so hard to describe to have a place that can bring me so much joy when I cross the property line. I never thought it was possible, and everything I do and think of now is just in a perspective of, you know, how can we have more fun at this place and make it better and safer, you know? It's definitely taken me from more of like, the guy who caused the liability to the guy who looks at the liability and is like, I mean, dude, it's just everything has transformed and it's just been an amazing experience.
It's awesome. And like, I know we're grateful to have access and come here and have fun. And
anytime.
You've done an unbelievable job with it, which has been no small feat. And I mean, you know, speaking of work and effort, I mean, you've been doing this now, you know, you're creating content for a living for what, 4 or 5 years now?
Yeah, like seriously for 4 or 5 years.
Yeah, and you're one of like a very few guys that, you know, I relate to this, like you've just done what you love to.
I really try to, yeah.
And even like to your core, like when I talk to you about, you know, deeper things and business and things, like you were just to your core, just wanting to have a good time And we align very much on like, do what you enjoy and the rest kind of follows.
That is like where you and I nail it. Cause every time we think of an idea, it's like, yeah, like, you know, that is gonna cost us a little here and a little there, but it's just what we actually want to do.
Right.
Versus, you know, just doing it for, you know, the biggest profit or the biggest, you know, like we really aim for what's best for the people and the fun, like, yep. That, and that's what I really liked about hanging out with you.
Fun always wins.
Seriously does, man. You can't stop it.
So you obviously, I mean, you've got some pretty wild builds, and you've been, I mean, how long have you been, obviously you're known for drag racing. I think you, yeah, and your Corvette are like very synonymous.
Definitely.
Is that the car you started in?
So, no, I when I started my YouTube channel, I had a C7 base model Corvette, and Pro Charger used it as one of their test cars. So I had a Pro Charger on it, pretty rad car. And like, you know, I worked at 1320 Video, so that's how I paid for the car, but I didn't use it for any content. And I was like, you know what, I'm gonna start filming my own videos. So that was like my original car, was C7 Corvette on the channel. And then really Leroy, though, the bodiless car was the biggest thing. You know, I made the hefty investment at the time of $5,000 and bought it off of eBay, sight unseen, risky maneuver. And car came and I was like, wow, this thing really is a piece of crap. You know, like bent frame, if you put it on the lift, to this day, you know, only three arms touch. Like James knows to adjust the lift on one corner just because it's framed so bent in the car. Yeah. I'm like, that car was definitely the biggest asset to the Cleetus McFarland show for sure, just growing, drag racing it.
And now it does what in a quarter mile?
770s at like just under 190.
Yeah, that's
a stick car, yeah.
Insane in a stick.
Super fun.
So would you say, is that car, is that like project and that kind of what kind of launched you and had you realize, yeah, man, I can do this stuff that I love and people want to and watch it, and obviously your fun personality and that energy carries through. Like what was that switching point for you?
The switching point was Kyle Loftus, the owner of 1320 Video, when he told me, he was like, there's more to the Cleetus McFarland than what you're currently doing, which all I did, you know, in like 2015 and 16 was make Facebook videos, just funny, like literally just funny stuff. Like I would just do like pranks, you know, on like car guy, like my buddies. And then he was like, there's more to this. Like you could, you know, this new style of YouTube with vlogging where you kind of just film what you're doing. He's like, I think you really can do this. And he helped me take those steps and, you know, kind of motivated me, but showed me the right path. And that was kind of the flipping point, was when I went to law school because I didn't know what to do with my life. And I was like, wow, this sucks. I was like, I better figure something else out quick. So while I was in school, I started the YouTube channel. And that really, like, I just remember waking up one morning and we had like 1800 views on our video we'd posted the day before. And I was like, this is it. I called Cooper. I'm like, dude, we're going all out. You know, I was like, meet me at the house after class. Like, we're filming every day, you know. That was a turning point. All kind of happened at once.
Is Cooper been a really long time friend of yours?
So I met Coop in college, and just he was the only other car guy I knew, you know. So I went to college as a car guy, hung out with a lot of non-car guys, met Coop because he's another car guy, and hired him at 1320, got Kyle to hire him, so I had some help on the social media stuff, and then, you know, we just never stopped hanging out.
Yeah, you guys got a good synergy for sure.
Yep.
So it's okay, so drag racing, so I've watched you drive, and I'm not just saying this, but you're a wheel man. Like you can jump in, I've let you jump in our Mustang. Obviously wheel a neighbor is no small feat. She's a little sloppy.
Crown Vicks, they drive themselves.
It's a little bit. Not they straight sideways, I don't know. I've driven it, it's tough. And so been fun.
For the record, you've driven it and it was the coolest ride along of my life. There's actually a video titled Craziest Ride of My Life. So you made it look easy, but I'm building that skill for sure.
Yeah, I mean, look, we know to your core and your heart, you're a fun haver, and you're obviously, you know, going from drag racing, You're now playing, you know, side by sides, off road. Like, yep. You do everything. Like me, you just enjoy fun and being behind the wheel.
Motorsport.
But you've been really, you know, you've been. I see you when you see drifting. You got like a little sparkle in your eye.
I definitely you've obviously really just built like a car. Drifting.
So how, like, did you being coming from drag racing? And obviously, you know, there's a lot of guys that are like, specific in drag racing, that are just like, nah, drift and stuff. We're not into that. But like, were you ever that? And then were you ever that?
So this is how it works. Started road racing.
Okay.
So like, I used to be the all drag racing sucks, but then I announced drag racing events. I got really into it. The thing with drag racing is it's your adrenaline level is super high, but it's for a short period. Drifting, it's like the adrenaline's there, but for a longer period. Yeah. So like for me, I love drag racing for that 7 seconds, but then it's like you're in the pits working on your car.
Right.
You know, and I'm more of the guy like, this is why James and I get along so well, because James loves working on cars. I love driving them. So, you know, drag racing is definitely more proportioned towards working on your car than driving it. Whereas now I'm getting to that, like, I like drifting a lot because you're out there for a while.
Yeah.
And then you go change your tires, you know? Now, granted, we do break some stuff.
Of course, as such as anything.
But it's nice to have that switch off from the, like, super high adrenaline stuff to the kind of longer lasting stuff, the drifting. Yeah. So being able to make that transition with the Freedom Factory especially has been key.
Yeah, it's been fun to watch you. And now you've obviously bought a new drift car.
Yep, Donnie.
Yeah, which you're actually going to drive for the first time today as soon as this Florida rain stops blessing us.
Yes,
right?
Sir. I'm excited.
And yeah, so speaking of more excitement, so that's another thing for me. So like that's the off-road. So I'm excited to maybe get you out to King of the Hammers one day.
I know, we've been
because
talking.
That's like another level of like that long, sustained fun.
Yep, we've been talking. We've been talking about this off-road thing. I don't know if we'll tease it. We'll tease it right there.
Yeah, I think it needs to happen. But
some things coming later this year.
Anyway, we got a lot of fun things that we've been talking about, and I'm excited, and I'm pumped to be here.
Yeah.
And yeah, I think we can go out there.
I think
have some fun.
One of the best parts about meeting you guys too is like there's so many guys that I deal with, you know, that really like to do cool stuff but don't make it happen, and like everything we've ever dreamed up so far we've made happen.
For
like,
sure.
You call me and you're like, hey, we should go to the factory and do this and this and this, and then you guys show up and we do it. And like the day we shot the video for the Freedom Factory, I'm like, hey, this is what I gotta do. And you're like, cool, on a plane, done.
Yeah.
You know, it's like I've been able to just make things happen with you, and I freaking love that. Your whole team shows up, you guys are ready. It's just so sick.
We are professional fun havers.
I know.
It's not a joke. It's not just a name.
I'm still working on, like, when I see the rigs pull up, I'm like, damn, we're going to have some fun.
Yeah, for me, like, that's my, like, in my business, I mean, you can ask any of my guys, but, like, you know, you're only as good as you surround yourself with people you surround yourself with, 100%. Right? I mean, you know that. And so for me, like with the team, like I'm always trying to make sure everybody's having fun. Because if we're not having fun, then it sucks. And then it's
totally
a job.
100%.
And I don't want a job. I was in IT and I've had plenty of jobs. I don't want a job. I want to just fun.
Yeah, one of my biggest fears in life is like, I would never want James or Cooper to like see their phone and me calling. Like, you know what I mean?
Oh, yeah.
So like taking care of your guys with that in mind, I think it's so crucial. Like, you don't ever want your people to be like,
what
you know,
now?
Like,
yeah.
Who's calling? Like, what now? Like, what do we got? You know?
Yeah.
So, I go into work every day hoping that I can make everybody have just a great day. And, you know, like, I
absolutely
see you do the same thing.
Well, let's go have some fun. Speaking of fun,
I mean, we got some fun to have for sure, brother.